Coffee. Oh, it's coffee. Coffee, the best antidepressant.
Welcome back, my Chonker viewers, and we're back with another Space Engineers video, because I know that's what you all like. If you enjoyed this content, please leave a like down below and subscribe if you haven't already.
All right, we are back in Space Engineers, looking at our new Basilisk class frigate. So last episode, I showcased and showed you how you can incorporate a tight, small, compact interior into your ships, your frigates, and yeah, you're more than welcome to use the designs that I've done or incorporate some ideas that I have and, you know, change it up. The most important part is if you have an industrial looking ship, I think the interior wall looks great. They also have a second interior wall that's I think it's a sci-fi one, which I think is a part of a DLC. I don't know. You guys will let me know in the comments down below. But it's, yeah, the sci-fi interior wall. And it looks a little more, I don't know how you would say it, a little less, industrial and more, pleasant. So this may be a better type of interior wall for your ship. So we made crew quarters for four crew members, two co-pilots, and then, or sorry, one co-pilot, and then the four pilots of the ship or engineer. We have a bathroom and a shower, along with their locker room and armory, so they can all gear up and get in and just head out. We have the cafeteria, which is, everything's lit up. Everything's just like softly lit dough. Let's see if I can change that. Let's turn the engine room lights down. Kitchen lights, I want those a little brighter. Because we don't have any lights on this side. That's fine. That looks a little better. Yeah, we got a couple tables, and we got the kitchen and behind, and we actually have access to the cargo. So, I mean, realistically, if you're in survival and you needed, like, I don't know, like a med kit or something, you can access it all throughout the ship. If we come back here, we can get into the engine room, and then the engine room is right over here on the side through this airlock. So we just have to open it up. You notice that it gets significantly darker, and then you can walk down, and then we're in this nice red industrial looking area, kind of lit up from the other room, which is fine. Actually, I may be able to add, yeah, okay, I'm gonna add the light there, and we'll turn those red. We can get to the gravity generator from down here, and then you can reach the other side and repair all of those gyros, and you can even, if you have to, you can squeeze by back here to get at the reactors. So what we're going to work on today is actually the upper deck. So if we come through here, we have this nice staircase up here. So we've got a lot of room to work with. Let me just turn on the light. And I think what I'm going to design is in this section over here, kind of over here in this area, is going to be maybe the captain's quarters. And then, actually, well, there is a lot of room up here. All right, so never mind. So I think because I have enough room up on the top up here, I think this area is going to be the captain's quarters. And I can easily section that off. And then down below will all be the med bay, cryo room. I may be able to fit some cryo chambers in here. See how it all works out. I also have to fit some sort of staircase going up, probably something like right there. And the med bay is most likely going to be like right here. So what do I have to work with? So sometimes you will have to cut away the ship just to get components to line up or get to certain spots of your ship, like you all see I'm doing right now. I'm going to have to make sure everything's connected and hooked up, I'm going to have to connect this up to the top right here. So we can fit a med bay. And we can have one of these CAT scans. I don't think they actually have any real purpose, but... Oh, actually, what we're going to need is we're going to need an air vent. So we'll put that there. And then have the air vent here. And then we can put the CAT scanner in front, so we actually have oxygen pumping into this room. And you can't even see the air vent, so it looks like it's kind of hidden, tucked away back there. Make those white. And now for the staircase. So I may cut away here just a little bit. Yeah, that'll be fine, like that. And then we can take a ramp, flip it upside down. So now we have more floor to work with. And then we can put an air vent right here for the captain. I believe I have an air vent there. We can put an air vent in here. Now, there's a certain technique that I like to use in all of my ships, if you're noticing now, and that's to put an air vent in each room. Now, the reason why I do that is because, I mean, it's really not necessary. And obviously, you know, with Space Engineer's limits, you're not going to be having giant epic battles all the time. But we could be with this awesome server. But the idea is, if one part of the ship gets breached, all the air isn't getting sucked out right away. It's going to get sucked out of that area. So for instance, if my if the side right here was being shot at and then blown through and it's releasing air into space, if I close this door and every other door in the ship, only this hallway is going to get their air sucked out. So if people were sleeping in the crew quarters, no one's going to suffocate, no one's going to die. And same with inside the cafeteria. As well as if this staircase was closed off, now this whole staircase is completely filled with oxygen and it's not being, essentially it's not having its oxygen taken away. All right, so let's continue then. Now what I'm going to do now is make kind of the border of each room. Where do I want each room to sit and stay? And it's very, very... There are some blocks that I really enjoy using for actual walls. These blocks include the half slab, catwalks on their side. Now that passageways have this amazing block, I tend to use that a lot now, as well as interior walls, just to... you know, if I want a little more detail. But I actually try and not use the interior wall as much, especially with these like smaller slender builds, especially of the Tundari style, because this block takes up a lot of space. Whereas if I have this, now I have a wall that separates and is perfectly pressurized on both sides. I could actually put a door and then pressurize this area. And I actually have some space over here, so I may be able to use this space for, I don't know, some sort of control room or something. But that's definitely just, you come in here, and this is going to be the med bay. So now, our engineers have actual cryo chambers, so, I mean, there could technically be crew rotations if they're going on long journeys, so people would stay in stasis while the others would work, and then they would swap out. And then this amount of space just gives us a lot of room for details. All right, so now that we have every section sectioned off, we have the captain or the deck right up on the top. Then right behind, we have the captain's quarters. And if we come down these staircases right down here and make our way over here, we have the med bay. And then this central staircase and this little area, which I kind of want to add a little more. Also, I have to hook it up, so maybe I won't add anything. It's just a space to hook things up, which is fine. All right, so now for this part, I'm just going to add a little bit of detail, so I will be right back. my god! Did I cut you short? Oh, I'm so sorry! Oh!
You wanna know what happens next?
You wanna know what it looks like now? Oh, you're gonna have to wait for the next episode! But that's all I have for today. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll be back with some more Space Engineers content in the future. Maybe play some Call of Duty? Minecraft? Just to keep me from going fucking insane. Also, I was considering on checking out some video games that you guys suggest in the comments, like Elite Dangerous, and there was another one that I forgot. But if you keep commenting ideas and it gets enough likes and enough attention, I might play it. We're almost to the Discord server! Yay! I'll be coming out with a video about all my generals and who is a general, who isn't a general. But more details on that later. Thank you all so much for watching. And if you want to be a part of this awesome army, consider subscribing down below. And if you like the video, like it. Leave a like. Share my video. Tell your friends and family about it. But that's all I have for today. Thank you all so much for watching. And I'll see you in the next. And as always, Chonkers out.